was never a dull moment in the Tiger House, but I am delighted to be able to tell you that Yuki not only pulled through, she is here and looking very beautiful indeed. Hello, little one. Caleb, sorry, she's always going to upstage you, I'm afraid.
Yeah, they both are, to be fair.
Well, to have two quite major operations in almost as many days was horrible to you all.
Yeah, it was, but she pulled through and she's really fit and healthy now.
She's really fit and healthy. I mean, you can't even see. Can I have a look at you? No, says Rusty, you've got to look at me. Rusty, you are incorrigible. You've always got to steal the show, haven't you? So has she got any sort of scarring, any kind of...
No, it's all grown back. She's been absolutely fine.
I mean, I do remember, you know, even 6 months ago, there was quite a lot of argy-bargy between them over food. Now.
So we're starting to teach them table manners now.
Right.
We've just trained them to either side of a post, so Rusty feeds on the right-hand side of a post to us as keepers, and then Yuki feeds on the left, and they've both learned to get into those positions and take chunks nicely, so that we can do it wherever they are.
Yeah.
If we want to get them over, they both line up, and it works an absolute treat.
Well, is this something that you are prepared to share with me?
Yeah, sure.
And the public, and see if your training really has paid off?
Yeah, I'm fairly confident it'll pay off. You can take Yuki, so you take the left-hand side.
So I'm going to take this side, and this is the post that we're going for.
This is the post, yeah.
Okay. But Rusty is right here now. Shall I grab this meat here?
You grab that pot.
Okay.
And ideally, we try and keep the paws down on the floor.
Okay, you don't want them jumping up.
No, because Yuki will actually protect her food from her brother and actually paw against the bars, and she might jump up a little bit.
Right.
Because she's missed out on occasion, and obviously she got that injury, she's very defensive about food.
Right, now at the moment, Caleb, it's not looking great. She's on the wrong side.
No.
So,
Rusty, you're going to come and get some food?
Come on, Yuki.
Yuki, you've got it.
Good girl.
So if you come a bit closer to me, and then you can take Yuki that side.
Yuki. Here you are. Good girl. Save your paws on the floor. Good girl. Paws on the floor. Good girl.
So they pick it up quite easily and they will jump each other to get to the food.
Good girl. So what will happen? Because, I mean, now that they're eating independently and they're weaned, what happens next to these tiger cubs?
They'll slowly drift away from mum, to be honest. And Rusty will probably slowly drift away a little bit faster than Yuki.
Yeah.
Generally, you find big cat males are 6 months ahead of their sisters. And Rusty's already starting to distance himself. He follows around the section and scent marks on his own, and he's starting to do things already ahead of his sister's pace.
Well, the fantastic thing is, you know, this hopefully is the start of a really successful breeding program.
Yeah, hopefully we'll have a dynasty of tigers from Redden and Yana, so hopefully. But these two are very special to us.
Look at you. You are beautiful, and my goodness, you know, you're right. There's absolutely no sign of any scar under her chin, is there? You're perfect. Yes, you are. Please don't give Caleb and Amy any more trouble. Do you think that might be the last bit of drama, or is that hoping for way too much?
Yeah, I hope so, but it's tigers and they're big cats, so there probably will be more drama, but obviously we don't want any more drama.
We would like you just the way you are.